The other thing is try to praise your husband for little things he does. Call him sweetheart. What, sweetheart? I cannot. Oh, I feel ashamed. Maybe before we got, when we were engaged, we, but now you tell your husband every now, what's his name? Ya Akhtar, come here. Like this? No. Don't you say Habibi Akhtar? Well, no, it's up to you. See? See? Do you say to her Habibati?
Yeah, I say Begum.
Ah, Begum, it's okay. I don't. So unfortunately, many of us Muslims, unfortunately, I don't know about non-Muslim, but many of us Muslims, we feel shy to tell our wife Habibati or husband Habibi in front of anybody. What's wrong? You get credit from it, and that is the idea that crush his heart and stay in his brain and heart. My sweetheart is telling me Habibi. Here in America, we can use sweetheart. You want to use the English word? Say, my sweetheart. Your husband is a sweetheart for you, and you are a sweetheart for him. And there is no shame to say it in public. No, no, in Muslim, no, no. Oh, your first name?
Shahida.
Shahida. You may tell her, Shahida, come here, Shahida. Is this the way we talk to her in public? No. There is no harm saying, my sweetheart, Shahida, would you kindly? Ah, would you kindly? I'm the boss. No, you have to tell her, would you kindly? If you don't tell her, would you kindly, why should she listen to you? Even if you have a servant in your custodian or whatever, cleaning janitorial, you have to tell him, please, can you do this? But then, do you want the result or you want to fight? The result is, first, smiling. Third, how to talk to each other, husband, wife, to each other. And the most appealing to the inner heart, to catch her and keep her in your hand or in your heart as a sweetheart. Is it not true Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has reminded us in the Quran in many places that your wife has been created from you for you? Not your wife, he said your spouse. Means both of you. Your husband from you for you. You are from him for him. In Surah Rum, Allah says it very clearly. وَمِنْ آيَاتِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنْفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّ وَرَحْمَةً إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِقَوْمٍ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. Among the miracles of Allah in you that He created for you, from you, your own spouse, so as you can dwell in peace and tranquility. He created for you, from you, your own spouse. He didn't say for the husband or the wife. He said for both of you. Which means your husband and your wife, you are from each other, for each other. So as you can live in peace and tranquility. And you will never, ever live in peace and tranquility unless you get married. It's not easy. But we get married and we fight. I said, because you are not doing what Allah and Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told us how to treat each other. So in order to live in peace and tranquility, you have to get married, number one. But you will never live in peace and tranquility inside the house unless you have these two definitions or adjectives that Allah has said it in the Quran. وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً. What is mawadda? Husband, wife. Is to talk to each other with a sweet tongue. Love. Love? I love her. You have to tell her every day. Honey, sweetheart, I love you. Sure. At the age of 40, 50, 60, you say to your wife, I love you. Well, what's so? Miss my wife, I love you. Habibati, can you do this? Well, there is no harm. This is mawadda. Mawadda, how to approach people with love, with affection, with sympathy and concern. If you don't tell your wife that one, well, I don't help. I don't blame anybody except the brother who doesn't want to crush his ego to tell his wife, my sweetheart. Yes, you have no right to tell any lady, my sweetheart. No, none of them is a sweetheart. Respected sisters, yes. But your own wife is to tell her every day that in order that she feels loving to you, still attached to you, and in her prayer, she'll make special dua for you in your absence that you don't know. Mawadda. It says, رَأْسُ الْحِكْمَةِ مَخَافَةُ اللَّهِ. There is another hadith, رَأْسُ الْحِكْمَةِ بَعْدَ الْإِيمَانِ بِاللَّهِ التَّوَدُّدْ إِلَى النَّاسِ. The climax of wisdom after believing in Allah is how to approach and talk to people. Mawadda, how to approach people in a very sweet tongue so as they can at least listen to you. You are No, you see, unfortunately, now we have dictators in the whole Arab world. Yes or no?
Yes.
One family, I'm doing family counseling, you know, he said, we are all that dictator in a small capacity toward our wives and our children. We are very militant, tyrant dictator against our wives and our children. For that reason, Allah brought us a big dictator to harass us in our country. Because we are dictators, so he brought us Muammar Gaddafi on one side, Saddam Hussein on the other, Hafez Assad on the other, and everybody everywhere in the world, tyrant dictators, because we are militant tyrant dictators against our wives and against our children, so we deserve it. So, mawadda, huh? Rahma, mercy. Shura, if we don't have these, why you are married? Sex? Are we, animals have sex? You think that for the sake of intercourse, a husband and wife only live for the sake of intercourse? We are worse than animals. Animals have love toward each other, yes or no? Don't you see two cocks are fighting? Why? Two cocks, have you lived on farm? You see cocks are fighting or not? Why? I don't know. Unless you take a course in animal husbandry.
For the
hen. For the hen, you see, very good. Why? She gave a clue, at least. When a cock has hen, his wives, he will never tolerate to see another cock approaching his wife. This is my wife, and this is my wife, and this is my wife, and this is my wife, because he has lots of wives. And you know, in the Bible, in the Torah, there is no limit for wives, by the way. In the Christianity and Judaism, there is no limit for number of wives. The only religion that has limited the number of wives is Islam. And Islam did not encourage extra wives unless there is a reason. Reason could be war, like Bosnia, what to do with the extra ladies, either prostitute, mistresses, whatnot, God forbid, or you men, you assume a responsibility, have two or three, in order to take care of them, otherwise there'll be vulgarity, immorality. But too much, you said, what can you do? So, the idea of, where are we now? Anybody can refresh my memory? Yeah, God bless you. So the cocks are fighting among themselves, telling them, you crazy cock, get out of my way. This is my wife. You have no right to touch her. Do you see goat, male goats? What they do? They do worse than that. They go and fight head to head because of the same reason. You know, in the Arab world, they say rasak ras tais. Tais means goat, male, hardliner. There is no way of convincing you. They say much more about a man like this, not only like a male goat your head is like, even if you hit your head in the wall will be broken, but your head will not be broken. We cannot convince you. You are too tough for us. You are worse than a male goat. We shouldn't be like that. But at least, have you ever seen the moral life of a pig with his wife? We are still talking about husband-wife, huh? You didn't take a course in animal husbandry. See, a male pig, after he has sex with his wife, he leaves her. In front of him, she'll go to another, or another comes to her. She doesn't mind, and the husband doesn't mind to see her in front of his eye, mating another male pig in front of him. So what? I have sex with her, let another enjoy her in front of him. Doesn't care. It's the worst animal ever that we have read about or knew about. Have you heard about the camel's life, morality? Listen, go to Arabian Peninsula, they'll tell you the life of morality of a camel. If a camel is mating his wife and he sees a human being, he leaves his wife and come and hit him and hit him and hit him, crush him on the earth, ground till blood comes from the head. You have no right to come and watch me when I am with my wife. That is the morality of a camel. There are some birds in Arabian Peninsula, similar thing. They'll follow you to chase you till they poke your blood from your head because you are watching that bird with his wife. Have you heard about the wasp society in America? Wasp, what was wasp? Yes, white Anglo-Saxon Protestant. In LA and Chicago and big cities like this, these are the white Anglo-Saxon, when they have parties in the scientific meetings, when they finish, they want to go back to their rooms in the hotel. Give me your wife, take my wife. In that night, they are doing it. Do you want to know worse than that? These are the white Anglo-Saxon. Now there are some crazy Muslims, huh? Crazy Muslims from Middle East. They are repeating the same misery of those. These are the byproducts of the American education system. Recently, I have heard worse than that. Only last month, I have heard something worse. Have you heard about the Muslim gay club? The Muslim homosexual club in LA? I say, why to call it Muslim? Say anything, but you don't abuse the word of Islam for the sake of doing immorality. This is the way to accuse Islam, and you and me are being accused innocently because they want to destroy the image of Islam by using the word Muslim. Like the American and the European were destroying the image of Islam by saying Islamic atomic bomb. Is there something in technology called Islamic atomic bomb? No. They want only to defame Islam. Now, I'm sorry to go too far.